Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about the topic the mechanisms for control 5th unit. 5th unit consists of there are two topics. One is for governor and another one is for gyroscopic coupled. The gyroscopic coupled problems are uploaded in SNS courseware. Today we are going to discuss about the two three problems in governors. Okay. First of all, what is meant by governor? Okay, the governor regulate the mean speed of an engine whenever there are load variations. Okay, it is one of the speed controlling device. When the load of an engine increases, so automatically the speed will be decreases. Therefore, it becomes the necessary to increase the supply of working fluid. Okay, at the same time, if the load conditions may be decreased, mean automatically the speed will be increases. At the same time, the fuel consumptions will be reduced. Okay, the governor automatically control the supply of the working fluids of the engines with everywhere varying the load conditions and keep the mean speed within the certain load limitations. Okay, this is the definition for governor. The function of the governor is to maintain the speed of an engine within the specified limit whenever there is a variation in load. Okay, simply it is called speed controlling mechanisms. There are centrifugal governors. What is the difference between governor and flywheel means? It is the variations in wheel load. The fluctuation, the flywheel means the function of the flywheel is to reduce the fluctuation of speed. Okay, at the same time can be stored in the maximum energy in the flywheel. Okay. These are all the various types of governor. First one is for centrifugal governor and second one is for inertia governor. There are different types of centrifugal governors are available, means pendulum type, that is bar governor type, and other load type means deadweight governors and spring control governors. These are all the different types of deadweight governors, means that we have added the central load to the bar governor, means that is called quarter governor and royal governor. And again, the poet governors are classified into Hartnell governor and Hartung governor and Wilson Hartnell governor and Pickering governor. Okay. This is centrifugal governors. Consists of two ball arrangements, that is called fly balls. And the balls are arranged in the links and the finally the sleep movements in horizontal, sorry, vertical direction, and this is for horizontal movements. And the this is for arms. These two arms are connected to the balls. And finally, the sleeve mechanism is controlled, connected to the engine. Whenever the load of the engine decreases, means the engine and governor speed will be increases. At the same time, the increase the centrifugal force acting on the balls, and the ball move radially outward direction. Okay, well, this is the supply of working fluids and throttle valves. Will the entire mechanism will be connected to the sleeve of the centrifugal governors. Okay, these are the characteristics of centrifugal governor. And the terms of governors used, first one is for height of the governor pitch, which means the height of the governor. The ball, the increasing of the ball distance will be bigger ball, and the topmost corner is fixed the height of the governor. And the rotation is called radius of rotation. This is called radius of rotation. And equilibrium speed, mean speed, sleep lift means how much amount of the ball will be lifted to the initial positions, and centrifugal force means FC, controlling force and governor effort, and the power of a governor, maximum minimum equilibrium speed. These are the important terms and conditions are used in governor. Okay, these are the some animations videos. Then what governor? Bar governor FC, and the weight mass of the ball in kg weight, and W means the mass into g, g value is 9.81, and T means the tension of the arm in newtons. If the ball rotated, means automatically the arm will be increased or decreased due to the tension law, and omega means angular velocity of the arm, then real radius of the bar, rotation of the bar, and centrifugal force, and H means height of the governor. Okay, we have to calculate the centrifugal force by using this formula m omega square into r. M means the mass of the balls in kg, and omega means angular speed of the governor, and r means the rotation, the radius of rotation of the particular governor. Okay. These are the some important formulas in our calculating the height of the governor, means we have to use this equation 8, 90, 20 by n square. N square means the mean speed of that particular governor. Okay. First, these are the some problems. Same again, portal governor means you have to use the central load in the sleep position. Okay. This is the main difference between the ball governor and the portal governor. All other remainings are same. Balls are arranged in the arms conditions of the sleeve. The central load is acted upon the sleeve. These are the important notations used in that mass and weight. Mass are the central loads. The small mass of the balls and the capital M means mass of the central load in kg. Okay. These are the angular speed of the balls in radian per second. And the FC means centrifugal force acting on the ball M omega squared into R. Then alpha and beta means the angular inclination of the arm in the vertical position. This is mean alpha. Then beta means the angle of inclination of the wing to the vertical position. Okay. This is the relations used to calculate the speed of the mean speed of the portal governor. Okay. We have to solve one small problem. The problem is that the portal governor has two equal arms. The portal governor arms, the upbound governor arms are equal distance, 250 mm long. And pivoted on this axis of rotation, each ball has the mass of 5 kg. This is 5 kg. And the mass of central load of the sleeve. Central load means the capital M will be given 25 kg. Then the radius of rotation of the balls is 150 rpm. That means R1 and R2. Then Lipton 200 mm when the governor is in maximum speed. If the sleeve is moved from 150 to 250 mm means automatically the speed of the ball will be increased. So R1 value is 150 mm and R2 is 200 mm. Finally, we have to calculate the maximum and minimum speed ranges of the speed of the portal governor. Okay, listen please carefully. The given data are first one PP and BD means PP and B. Upper and lower arm distance is 250 mm. That means 0.25 mm. Then ball small m is equal to 5 kg and capital M is equal to 15 kg. Okay, these are all the given data. First, we have to calculate the minimum speed. R1 is equal to under the conditions of 0.15 meter distance means. First, N1 means minimum speed. We have to calculate the height. H1 is equal to, from that diagram we have to use that relations PP squared minus PG squared. We have to calculate the H1 height of the initial position. Then automatically we will calculate the minimum speed. N1 is equal to small m mass of the ball and capital M means mass of the central load. And 895 H1 is already we have to calculate the height of the upper or minimum load. We have to automatically you have to substitute all these values are known values from that given data only, you have to take it out. Finally, you have to calculate the minimum speed level is for 133.8. Then automatically you have to calculate the maximum speed of the portal governor N2 which denotes the maximum speed of the portal governor. Okay. First you have to calculate the H2 height of the lower arm by using its previous problems. Okay. Sorry, previous diagram. Then you have to calculate the N2. How to calculate the range of speed means automatically you have to difference between the maximum and minimum speed is called the range of speed. It is for the simple problem. Then another one more problems. Same again, the portal governor are each of 250 mm long and pivoted at the governor axis. The mass of the each ball given small m given 5 kg and central sleeve mass load is capital M given 30 kg and the two different loads are different arm positions are given. R1 150 mm and R2 value is 200 mm. R1 value is 150 means we have to calculate the minimum speed at the same time. R2 values for 200 means at the time you have to calculate the at the time the distance of the arm will be reduced, mean automatically the speed will be increased. The radius of rotation of the arm value will be increased, means automatically the speed will be increased. Okay, this is the minimum quotient diagram and this is for maximum quotient diagram. Okay, listen, these are only given data. 250 and the upper lower number is same, 250 mm, and ball weight is for 5 kg smaller, and the central load value is for 30 kg, and distance between the arm first very small, the ball 150 mm, which means the governor rotated in a minimum speed, and the second mark to 200 mm means the governor rotated in maximum phase speed. How to calculate the speed ratios means we have to a difference between the maximum and minimum speed is called average speed of the or mean speed of the particular governor. Okay, first from the diagram we have to calculate the h1 means the height of the governor by using the upper arm value. We know that we have to calculate the minimum speed value m1. Small m will be given, mass of the balls are given, small m 5 kg, and m means central load value given, central load reference value given 40 kg. So automatically you have to calculate the minimum speed of the quarter governor. Then second, again from the diagram we have to calculate the height of the governor by increasing the arm position. So h2 value is 0.5 meter. Then we know that the maximum speed of the quarter governor is, again you have to substitute the small m, capital M, and the small m value, and the height of the governor value, we will get the n2 means, which means maximum speed of the governor. Then automatically you have to calculate the speed range of the governor is for n2 minus n1. N2 means maximum speed of the governor and n1 means minimum speed of the governor. These two problems are very important for solving the quarter governor. Okay. Same value, the range of the springs and slip given means you automatically have to use these relations. If the range of the friction value or friction value given means we have to use that relation, n1 equals small m means mass of the balls, g value g 9.81, f means friction value given means you have to use this relation, or otherwise you have to use m plus capital N divided by small m into 8.95 divided by h1. If the friction value is friction of the sleeve value not given means you have to use that relations, or otherwise you have to use these relations. Okay, same problem, same procedure. Thank you. Next class we will discuss about the Cohen governor values. Okay, please refer the coursework also.